a Sesame Street. Very excited today because my best friend in the whole world, Stubby, is going to come over and we're going to play. Wonder where he is.
Wow! Hey there! I'm really excited because my best friend in the whole world, Telly, is coming by and we are going to play. I wonder where he is.
Baby Bear!
Here he is!
Baby Bear!
Telly, you ready to play?
Hey, Baby Bear! I am so sorry. I can't play with you. My mom is taking me to visit my grandma.
Oh, no!
I'll miss you.
And I'll miss you!
Bye!
Bye!
Where is Snuffy? Oh, hi, Miles.
Hey, Big Bird. I have a message for you from Snuffy.
Oh, boy, what's his message?
He can't play with you today because he's taking Alice to the library.
Oh, no, really?
Yeah. Oh. Sorry, see you later.
Okay, bye, Miles. Oh, boy. My best friend's not coming to play today? Oh, boy. My best friend's not coming to play today.
Now, what am I gonna do?
Hi, I'm Susie Kabloozy, and I'm playing with my cat. Somebody come and play. Somebody come and play today. Somebody come and smile the smiles and sing the songs. It won't take long. Somebody come and play today. Somebody come and play. Somebody come and play my way. Somebody come and rhyme the rhymes and laugh the laughs. It won't take time. Somebody come and play today. Somebody come with me and see the pleasure in the wind. Somebody come before it gets too late to begin. Oh, somebody come and play. Somebody come and play today. Somebody come and be my friend and watch the sun till it rains again. Somebody come and play today. Meow! Oh, Piff! You came! Oh!
You know something? I'm glad you're here. Rubber Ducky's glad, too.
Outside our window, we see a lot of big buildings. The big buildings are very tall. I make copies of the buildings. So does my sister. We make our own buildings. It's fun to build with blocks.
Glad you sang with me. You're lucky, Mort. All I got in my lunchbox is peanut butter and jelly sandwiches.
Oh, would you like to sing a song right now?
Yeah!
Okay, it's a very simple little song. It's an echo song. Oh, hi, Big Bird.
Hi, Bird. Hi, Bob. Hi, kids.
Hi. What's wrong, Big Bird?
Well, Snuffy was supposed to play with me today, see? But he can't. I really wanted to play with him.
Oh, I'm sorry, Big Bird. Listen, we were just going to do a little song. Would you like to sing with us?
Maybe. Okay.
Great. Oh, hi, Baby Bear.
Hi, Baby.
Oh, hi.
Hey, Baby Bear, would you like to sing a song with us?
Well, I might as well. Kelly was supposed to play with me, but he can't.
Oh. Well, this is a little echo song. All you have to do is sing what I sing, okay? And want all of you to sing, too. Sing what I sing, sing after me. Be my echo, if you can be. Sing tra-la-la. Terrific. You know what? I'm going to make it a little harder this time. I'm going to try and trick you, okay? So you're going to have to listen very carefully, and you too. Here we go. Sing what I sing, sing after me. Be my echo, if you can be. Sing die, da, die, die, die. Catching yet. Sing fiddly diddly.
Diddly diddly.
I couldn't catch you.
That was good.
That was terrific.
That was so
you guys are great. You were great, Baby Bear.
Oh, thanks, Bob.
Thanks, Bob.
Okay, thanks a lot.
Bye.
You guys were great. Good. See you later.
Bye.
Wow, you were good, Baby Bear.
Oh, thanks.
And you
so
too, Big Bird.
Oh, thanks, Bob.
Oh, you know what? I have to give a piano lesson in about 5 minutes, so I have to be on my way. I'll see you later, okay?
Bye, Bob.
Okay, bye, Big Bird.
Bye. Gee. Now, what should I do today, now that my best friend Stuffy can't play?
Yeah, well, I have a wee little problem, too. What should I do today, now that my best friend Telly can't play? Well, take it easy, Big Bird.
Yeah, see you later. Bye.
Soft. Loud. Soft. Loud. Okay, loud.
And now, the number of the day. Do you know the number of the day? Rubber ducky does.
One lemon. Two lemons. Three lemons. Lemonade.
How old are you, Carrington?
Three. Yeah. Carrington is three.
Do you know what number I like best? It's three. Because today I am 3 years old. 1, 2, 3. And because I have 3 cuddly kittens. 3 dolls that I like a lot. 3 big brothers who play with me. And most of all because there are 3 candles on my birthday cake. 1, 2, 3. I love number 3.
Okie dokie, snack time, baby bear.
Yum, yum, yum.
One bowl of just right porridge for you.
Thank you, Ellie.
You're welcome.
You know, I should be eating the snack right now with my best friend, Telly. You know, we were supposed to play today, but he can't.
Oh, I'm sorry to hear that.
Yeah, I really miss playing with him.
Go ahead, eat your food.
Thank you.
Hi, Alan.
Oh, hey, Big Bird.
Hi again, baby bear.
Oh, hi, Big Bone.
Hi. May I have a birdseed milkshake, Alan, please?
Sure. What's wrong, Big Bird? He seems sad.
Well, my best friend Snuffy and I were supposed to play today, but he can't be here.
Hey, Big Bird, why don't you come around and sit with us, all right?
Well, usually I sit out here with Snuffy and we eat our snacks, but since there's no Snuffy today, maybe, okay.
Great. Come around and I'll get your shake, all right?
Mm-hmm. This is delicious porridge.
Oh, thank you very much. Mm-hmm. All right, sit right there.
Oh, okay.
And I got your shake all ready for you.
Okay,
thank you. All right. Now, let me get this straight, guys. Now, both of you were supposed to play with your best friends today, right?
Right. Yeah.
But your best friends can't play, so now you're sad because you've got nothing to do?
That's right.
Yeah, you hit the wee little nail on the head, Alan.
So you need to find somebody to play with.
Yeah, that would be nice.
Yeah, that would. You know, if you have any ideas, Alan, just feel free to let us know.
You guys, look next to you. The other side.
Hey, wait a second.
Are you thinking what I'm thinking?
I think I'm thinking what you're thinking. What are you thinking?
Well, that maybe we could play together.
That's exactly what I'm thinking. Maybe we can play together, huh?
Wait.
Now, why wouldn't it work?
Well, you know, I'm just so used to playing with Telly.
And I'm used to playing with Snuffy.
I know, you guys, but you should at least give it a try.
I don't know.
Well, Baby Bear, I suppose we could give it a try. It might work.
Yeah, you know, you're right, you know? You know, I'm a bear who likes to live on the edge. Mm. You know, I'm a thrill seeker by nature.
Good for you.
I'll do it. Hey, let's play.
Okay, hey, let's play.
Hey, let's play.
This is like the beginning of an interesting play date.
Play.
Sing. Different?
Play. Hey. Let's play.
So. Yeah, so, here we are.
Oh, yes. Here we are. At your cozy nest area.
Yep. Ready to play.
Yes, ready to play.
Yep, ready. Okay.
How should we start playing?
I don't know. Well, how do you and Telly usually start playing?
Oh, well, that's great. Telly usually, he runs in and goes, Baby Bell! Baby Bell!
Oh, really? Well, oh, I can do that.
Yeah.
Baby Bear, Baby Bear.
Ooh, that's not quite the way that Telly does it. You know what, maybe this whole Big Bird, Baby Bell playing together thing, it's not going to work out, I don't think.
No, it will. Let me try it again.
Okay, well, just try to be more excited, you know? Telly's a very excitable monster.
Yeah.
Yeah, do it like this. Baby Bell! Baby Bell!
Okay, Baby Bear, Baby Bear.
Now, that's a wee bit better. Yeah, but try to be more Telly-ish. You know, a little more gravelly voice, you know? Baby Bell! Baby Bell!
Okay. Baby Bear! Baby Bear!
That's pretty good. That's just like Telly.
Oh, gee, really? Well, you know what? I love how Snuffy always says hello to me, too. It's like, oh, hello, bird.
Oh, well, I can do that. Oh, hello, bird!
Well, it really wasn't much like Snuffy.
Oh.
So maybe you're right. Maybe playing together really wasn't such a good idea.
Well, hey, let me try it again, all right? I can do this. All right, I gotta think Snuffy. Got the big snuffle, big lumbering. Hello, bird.
Closer. Try to be more rumbly and snuffly, like, oh, hello, bird. Like that.
Hello, bird.
Hey, that was it. That was like Snuffy.
Oh, hello, bird.
Baby bear, baby bear.
Oh, hello, bird.
Baby bear, baby bear.
Oh, wait, well, now that we got the hellos just right, well, what should we play?
I don't know.
Me neither.
Well, I suppose we could always keep saying hello till we come up with an idea.
Okay. Oh, hello, bird.
Oh, baby bear, baby bear.
Oh, hello, bird.
Baby bear, baby bear.
Oh, dear. Oh, hello, bird.
Baby bear, baby bear.
Time we meet at work or the street, we always say hello. But you say
hola,
and I say hola.
It's a word that we both know.
Hola means hi, hello, not goodbye. Why, everywhere you go,
the girls say hola,
the boys say hola,
'cause hola means hello.
Just a fact, tell mommy and dad that hola's what to say. So try an hola.
Repeat, say hola.
Tell them hola's here to stay.
Latin from Alaska or from Spain or Nebraska will say hola when they mean hello.
Latins from Havana or Detroit or old Montana know that's just how the old greeting goes.
Latins from Queens and the hip Argentines say hola when greeting each other.
We know the way, we can all say hola, what's happening, brother? Take it from us and don't make a fuss, we want you in the know. So just say hola, come on, say hola, say hola instead of hello.
Baby bear.
Oh, hello, bird.
Baby bear, baby bear.
Oh, hello, Bud.
Oh, hi. Excuse us. We're just saying hello to each other till we figure out what to play.
Yeah. Well, I knew Itelli and I were going to play. Itelli was going to pogo stick up and down while I counted the boings. Oh, it would have been so much fun.
Hey, you know, we could still play that.
Yeah? Really? Oh, that's great. Okay, then you pogo stick, and then I'll count the boings.
Oh, but I can't pogo stick.
You can't? Oh, no. Well, you know what, Big Bird? We tried to play together, and it's not going to work out.
I'm afraid you're right.
Well, nice knowing you.
Yeah.
At least we gave it the old wee little try.
That's right, but... Hey, Baby Bear, I've got an idea. How about if you pogo stick and I count? I'm a really good counter.
Yeah? Well, that's not what I was going to do with Telly, but that's close enough. You know what? And I'm crazy enough to try it.
Good for you.
You know what? I'll be right back.
Okay.
Okay, I'm back. Let's play together. I will pogo stick, and you count the boings.
Okay, this should be good. This should be good. Okay.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, ready, get set, go. One boing, two boing, three boing, four boing, five, six, seven, eight, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20.
All right, this is great. This is almost like playing with Telly.
Oh, good. Want to do it again? Okay, I'll count again. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
You want to have a bouncy day. I'm telling you, I know the way you're done. Cause baby, soaring into space will put a smile back on your face. Yeah, John. It's time to get those muscles pumping. Come on and leap and skip and hop. Cause baby, once you start in jumping, you ain't never gonna stop. Yeah, jump. I want you to jump. Come on, every girl and boy, it's time to jump for joy. Now listen, people everywhere, throw up your arms, let down your hair and jump. Come on and take a flying leap, then try collapsing in a heap. Yeah, jump. Why not pretend that you can fly now? Yeah, get those feet up off the ground. Come on, grab a hunk of sky now, or leap a building in a single bound. Yeah, jump! I want you to jump. Come on, every girl and boy, it's time to jump for joy. Yeah, jump!
Jump!
You're a really great jumper, Baby Bear.
Well, thank you very much, Big Bird. And you know something? You are a great counter.
Thanks. See? We can play together.
Oh, we sure can play together. Hey, let's play.
Hey, what should we do next?
Well, let's see. What were you going to do with Snuffy today?
Oh, well, Snuffy was going to read me stories from his book.
Oh, well, I can do that.
Great. Well, here's Snuffy's book of nursery rhymes.
Wow, Snuffy read from that book?
Uh-huh.
That's like a huge book, and I'm like a wee little bear. I don't think I can even hold that book.
Oh, okay. Sorry, Baby Bear, I understand. At least we gave playing together a try. Okay.
Hold on a second, Big Bird. Like Papa Bear always says,
Son, if you don't twy, you'll never fly.
He always says that, huh? What's it mean?
I'm not quite sure, but I think it means that you gotta twy your howdest. You know, so that's what I'm gonna do. Twy my howdest to read the book just like Snuffy. And the first thing that I'm going to try to do is to hold the book.
Okay. Let me just open it for you.
Wow. That's a big one.
It is a really big book.
Okay. All right. Well, here we go. Okay. I'm holding the book.
Oh, that's great. Okay, I'll just listen.
Okay, let's see. All right, the first rhyme is... no!
Yeah, I don't remember that one, Baby Bear. Oh, Baby Bear, are you okay?
Oh, yeah, no problem, Big Bird. Okay, here we go. Here's one. Hickory, hickory, dock. The snuffleupagus ran up the clock. The clock went boom. The snuff got a broom. Hickory, hickory, dock.
Oh, I love that nursery rhyme.
Yeah, you know, this is just like playing with Snuffy, huh?
Yeah, almost like playing with Snuffy.
What do you mean, almost?
Well, when Snuffy reads, the book is usually on the floor, and he's on top of the book.
Hey, I'm doing the best I can, Big Bird.
Okay, want to read another?
Here's a cute one. Old Miss Snuffle lived in a shoe. She had so many cabbages, she didn't know what to do.
Little Jack Horner sat in the corner, eating a Christmas pie. He put in his thumb and pulled out a plum and said, "Oh, what a good boy am I." Why is he in the corner? Does he have to stay in the corner?
Yes, because corner rhymes with horner.
Oh, horner. I get it. Oops.
And now a poem about big and small by Ernie. That's me. Big is like this. It can reach the sky. And small is the teeny little super guy. I love that.
Ladies and gentlemen, the teeny little super guy.
Teeny little super guy pops right up before your eye. He's no bigger than your thumb.
Snap your fingers, here I come. Now stop me if you've heard this one.
Don't look in the sky, don't look in the sea. He's inside of you and me.
Did I ever tell you about the time?
You can't tell a hero by his side.
I'm just a teeny little super guy.
Beautiful day for a baseball game. Seventh inning, here at the parks.
Just a little while ago, I was watching some kids play a game of baseball and having lots of fun.
Okay, now the pitcher has the ball. Here's the pitch. He stretches. He throws, swings. A fly ball into center field. Looks like could be trouble. Center field falls.
Then I noticed another friend, Alice W. Gunkler. She was sad. I figured I'd see what the matter was. "Hi, Alice," I said. "Why so sad?"
"Those kids are rude,"
Alice said.
"I've been standing here for a long time, and they haven't even asked me to play."
"Well," I said, "maybe they don't know you want to play, Alice."
"Maybe you're right. Maybe they don't know I want to play."
"That's right," I told Alice. "You gotta tell people what you want. Otherwise, how will they know?"
"Into center field. Should be a routine play for the center fielder. Oh.
Ask them. The worst they can say is no." Alice asked,
"Would you guys let me play with you?"
The other kids looked at each other, and one of them said, "Sure. Why didn't you say something before?"
"Hooray!"
said Alice, and it was her turn at bat. "Take two and hit the right," I told her.
"Strike one. Strike two."
"Way to go, Alice! That was terrific!"
"How long
did I
right field?"
Alice doubled on the right field line. All the kids loved her. And my dentist tells me my new teeth will be ready in about a month.
You can't tell a hero by his size.
I'm just a teeny little super guy.
Oh, yeah.
This is going to be so much fun. Whoa.
Elmo?
Oh, hi.
Can I ask you and the kids a question?
Oh, ask away, Mr. William.
Well, suppose you all were playing baseball, you know, like this, like... Along came someone really different. I'm talking really different, like with one body, two heads, no waiting. You know what I'm saying? I mean, you know, horns on one head go up and horns on one head go down, and talks like this. Now, Elmo, would you ask them to take a hike, or would you and the kids ask them to join you and play baseball with them?
Well, that's easy, Mr. William. If Elmo and everybody here would ask us to play baseball with us, right, everybody?
Sure!
Sure!
Oh, that's real nice. Hey, but don't worry, that could never happen.
Hey! Play!
Ball!
Hey! Big man! Hey, you're out!
This is the small letter B, and it makes a sound like B. B is the first sound in the word bat. B is also the first sound in the word ball.
Anybody want to play baseball?
Is also the first sound in the word break.
Baby on a bongo board bed, he's having fun. Little bee with butter on a breakfast bun. Now both bees are basking on the beach in the balmy breeze.
Basking on the beach in the balmy breeze.
Boy, oh boy, oh boy, you gotta love these bees.
Bee.
Letter B.
It's a banana.
A banana.
No, it's not a banana.
It's a ballerina in a banana.
She's beautiful. The letter B.
Well, baby bear, so far we've said hello to each other, just like Telly and Snuffy do.
Oh, hello, bird.
Oh, baby bear. Baby bear.
Yeah, and then I pogo stick, and you counted the boings, just like I play with Telly.
Yeah, and then you read me some Snuffle nursery rhymes like Snuffy does when we play together.
Yeah, that was fun. Well, now what should we do?
Well, let me think. What else I play with Snuffy?
Well, let me think what I do with Telly.
Oh, you know, we don't have to play Telly and Snuffy games. Maybe we could play a Big Bird and Baby Bear game.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. I don't know, Big Bird. That's a little crazy. What kind of Big Bird, Baby Bear game could we play?
Well, there must be something we could do.
That's right. The letter of the day is the letter B. Thanks, kids.
Thanks, Miles.
No, Baby Bear. That looks like fun.
Yeah, it does.
Letter B.
Yeah, it's catchy.
Yeah.
What is it?
My name starts with two B's. Big Bird.
Wait a second here. My name starts with two B's, too!
That's right!
Baby Bear!
Hey, yeah. Since both of our names start with B's, why don't we do a Big Bird Baby Bear letter B cheer?
Yeah! I've never said that with anyone before!
Me either!
Well, then what are we waiting for? Let's do it!
Okay.
Big Bird! Baby Bear! Big Bird! Baby Bear!
Hey, you know,
We never would have done the Big Bird Baby Bear Letter B cheer if we didn't play together today.
I know. Let's do it again.
Yeah.
Okay.
Big Bird.
Baby Bear.
Big Bird.
That's him.
Baby
Bear. That's me.
Big Bird.
Baby Bear.
It was a day like any other in Begonia Park. Boring. I am so bored, said Bob.
I got the blues, said Bob.
Even Ben's got the blues, said Bob. Just then, a big blue bus bumped by. The bus went to a baby store. And those bugs began to cry.
It's a bee, the bees, the big blue bus is full of bees. It's
Bees in the big blue bus with blueberries and brie, baklava and barbecue, banana bread and broccoli. The bees buzz by with buttered buns. The bees in a bunch, they brought out bowls of buttermilk. The buzzing bees had come for brunch.
Bring more bread!
More baked beans!
Bologna!
Begonia Park was never better. Everybody bright and beaming, all because of this little letter, the little letter B.
Hey, everybody, it's time for Alpha Boy. Today's adventure B. Balancing baloney on my blue bicycle.
That was so funny!
Rubber Ducky thought it was funny too.
Big Bird. You know what, Big Bird?
am glad that Kelly came back, but you know what? I had so much fun playing with you.
And I'm glad Stuffy came back, but I had a lot of fun playing with you too, Baby Bear.
Bestest buddy! Biggest buddy! Get it in place and push really hard.
Thank you, Dorothy. Now, Elmo will ask a baby. Oh, hello, baby. How do you put on your jacket? Here. question for you. How many jackets are in a jacket parade? Let's count them and see. Jackets! Oh, very pretty. That's one. That's two. That is three. Oh, that's four. Oh, wow, nice purple. That's five. That's six. Everybody. Alma wants to know something else about jackets. Who wears them and who doesn't? Oh, Troy, come on. Gotcha. Tricycles don't wear jackets. But a kid riding a tricycle can wear a jacket. Wear jackets? They wear buns. Chairs don't wear jackets, even though they have arms. Too bad. Alma thought it looked nice. The two-headed monster does wear a jacket to keep warm and dry.
Whoa!
But it should have two hoods. Two-headed monster. Now Alma wants to know when do you wear a jacket? Alma's friend Eric put on his jacket one time and told Elmo all about it. Elmo's friend Eric was planting seeds because he wanted some flowers to grow. When all of a sudden, the wind started blowing. Ooh, Eric felt cold, but he didn't want to go in the house to get warm. He wanted to finish planting seeds. What was Eric going to do? Just then, Eric's mommy came out, and she gave him a jacket to help him keep warm. And she put it on Eric. Then Eric was nice and warm, and he could finish planting. And that's when Alma's friend Eric put on his jacket when it got cold.
I wish they made jackets for plants. Well, that's a ride.
Alma wants to know more about jackets. How can Alma find out more?
The Jacket Channel. All jackets all the time.
And now it's time for Famous Jackets in Nursery Rhymes.
First, Jacket be nimble. Jacket be nimble, jacket be quick. Jacket jump over the candlestick. Next, Jacket and Jill. Jacket and Jill went up a hill to fetch a pail of water. Jacket fell down and broke his crown. And Jill came tumbling after.
Whoa! Phew!
And finally, Little Jacket Horner. Little Jacket Horner sat in the corner eating his Christmas pie. He stuck in his thumb, pulled out a plum, and said, "What a good jacket am I!"
The end.
Stay tuned for Jacket Nicholson in 5 Easy Jackets, coming up next.
Thanks. But Alma wants to learn more about jackets. Where can Alma learn more?
Wanna talk to a jacket?
Oh, yeah, Alma can talk to a jacket.
Okay, I'll tell you a little about myself.
Okay.
These are my sleeves to put your arms in.
Wow.
Yep.
Yeah, yep. Look.
Oh,
Those are nice sleeves.
Thank you.
Now, what else does a jacket have?
Oh, well, let's see. I got pockets to put stuff in.
Yeah, look, there's nice pockets. You have something right in that pocket right there.
I keep tissues and rocks in there.
That's very good.
Yep, and this is my zipper. It closes and opens. Zip down, zip up, zip down, zip up, zip, 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 zip,
zip. Hey.
That's a motorcycle jacket. It keeps you warm while you ride a motorcycle.
Wow, Elmo loves a motorcycle jacket.
I'll be back.
Bye.
Oh, look, 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 jacket. Dorothy's imagining Elmo in a jacket. Ah! Vroom!
What else can Elmo do in a jacket?
You can smell pretty flowers in the motorcycle jacket.
Vroom, vroom.
You can feed your goldfish Dorothy in a motorcycle jacket.
Vroom, vroom!
You can even dream in your motorcycle jacket.
Vroom, vroom!
Oh, thank you for telling Elmo all about jackets, Jacket.
You're very welcome.
Oh, well.
Hug?
Oh, yeah.
Oh. Bye, Elmo. Zip, zip, zip,
zip, zip, zip, zip, zip, zip, zip, zip, zip. Oh, do you know what jackets do when they get dirty? Well, Elmo wanted to find out. So, Elmo made a video with this camera. And it's called, What Jackets Do When They Get Dirty by Elmo. Come on in, television. Oh, there you are. What took you so long?
Funding for Sesame Street is provided by the annual financial support of PBS viewers like you.